गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ एम डी शफी अहमद, ग्रेजुएट इन केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग, एम बी ए ऑपरेशंस एंड पी जी इन डेटा साइंस. टुडे वी विल सी हाउ वी कैन ब्रिंग ऑल प्लान डेटा इनटू योर सिंगल विंडो स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम लाइमस्टोन माइंस टू सीमेंट क्वालिटी पैरामीटर्स. एंड ऑल्सो वी विल सी द रिलेशन बिटवीन एनी टू ऑपरेटिंग पैरामीटर्स यूजिंग लीनियर एंड पॉलीनोमियल रिग्रेशंस कर्व फिट. With the help of this software or platform, we can monitor live data from limestone mines to cement quality and can take immediate corrections wherever necessary. It is not like Excel, for example, like data collection from users, data gathering, data sorting, and then visualizing, which consumes a lot of time even for an Excel expert. Other than above, we have different modules of plant management where we can schedule, assign, and track our day-to-day jobs. Let's start with how we can monitor plant data. Let's log in. Once we log in, let's comes to charts data. As of now, it is not available to all. It is only with my login for demo purpose. Here I have taken sections like limestone mines, raw mill quality parameters, raw mill running parameters, kiln feed quality parameters, kiln running parameters, clinker quality parameters, like that. And you can filter from any date, from day to date. You can take 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 6 months, 1 year, 5 years, 10 years, any date you can filter, and you can see the live charts, and you can see the charts of all the sections in a single window. Now let's start with LSF. For example, I am taking the limestone mines LSF for raw mill quality LSF. We have other parameters also. Whatever you want to see as a graph, whatever you want to compare the parameters with respect to other sectional parameters, you have all the list. For example, lime, LSF, silica modulus, aluminum modulus, residuon, 32 micron, 45, 73. All the data, whatever maximum data we can feed into our database. From there, we can fetch all the graphs, any data, very useful for decision making in data analysis. For example, in this case, I am taking LSF, raw mill. I will take, for example, we have number of parameters. For example, I will take total feed, I can take mill main drain kilowatt, any parameter, just I want to compare what is the effect of these parameters with respect to subsequent parameters. I will take raw mill total feed, here I will take LSF, kiln. Obviously, I will take kiln feed, how the kiln feed is running with respect to LSF in mines, raw mill, kiln feed, and what is the LSF in the clinker. And we have other parameters, what is C3S, C2S, what is liquid phase, NET, burnability index, what anything we can take. So now just click filter records, then we will get the graphs like this. See, limestone mines, raw mill, now I want to see. How you know, here in the limestone mines, I observe almost LSF is constant. Let's look at the raw mill quality LSF. So if I see raw mill quality LSF from June 29th, from 93, it is going up to 96. So what is the effect of raw mill LSF in the kiln feed? We can see here, we can see the same increasing trend in the kiln feed also. And we will see what is the effect on the kiln feed. We'll see here. We can see now the kiln feed started trend decreasing, 392, 380, 372. So what I am trying to make you understand, in a single click, in a single view, we can view all the parameters and compare and take the necessary corrective actions. So if this is a single window, we have the zoom options as per the window fit. You can zoom 70, 80, 100, whichever you like. So here we can see clearly how is the raw mill LSF, how is the kiln feed LSF, how is the kiln feed increasing or decreasing. For example, we can take residue on 90 micron. Let's filter. Now, how about the residue? Residue also we see there is some increasing trend from June 29th. Earlier it is 13.6, 15.58, 14.5. Now it is going 16.39, 16.53, 16.76, 16.79. So like this, we can see how it is affecting our kiln feed. What are the clinker parameters? You can in each parameter you can compare kiln feed. How is the kiln firing increase? Kiln coal firing, how much increase? PC firing, how much increase for residue? What is the C3S? How is the C3S? What is the liquid phase? Any parameter you can put and you can see in a single click. You can filter the dates. For example, here I put from June 06, 06. I can put, for example, 07, 07, 2020 to 1 month 08, 08, 2020. Let's filter the records. Now here, see the raw mill residue is like this. And let's see how is our kiln feed. See how is our kiln feed. This is in the decreasing trend. Let's come to zoom and see. So whenever there is a disturbance in the any parameters, immediately we can track what is the fault, and we can take the immediate necessary corrections immediately. Even we can put live data, whatever the data user input the data from limestone mines or from the laboratory, from kiln operation, we can directly connect to our DCS. All the live data we can track, we can monitor any parameter. You can compare with respect to how is the raw mill main drive, how is the raw mill main drive is varying, how is the vibration, how is the, you can filter raw mill main drive kilowatt, how is the kilowatt varying, and what is the parameter, how is the vibrations of the raw mill. So all the parameters in a single click we can put. Even now I put only single graph, we can put multiple graphs also. For example, in the limestone mines, let's take LSF, silica modulus, aluminum in a single graph, any parameter. Just click here, select, we can give checkbox option, select silica, aluminum, iron, lime, then you can plot four graphs and you can compare how is the effect on the subsequent parameters. This is one part. Now coming to regressions. We can compare any parameter with any parameter. We can take two parameters and we can see what is the relation. Let's start with kiln feed versus kiln, let's say kiln speed. So we can analyze what is the relation. Now you filter the records. See, here you will see the graphs. What is the correlation here? Now you can see why any kiln RPM is equal to 0.012 into kiln feed into 0.044. Here I put linear interpolation, polynomial third degree. This one is polynomial third degree, and this is the polynomial fifth degree, and this equation is for the polynomial seventh degree. So from this, mostly in our industrial cases, we can take linear relations, or we can go up to polynomial second degree. So we can have some idea what could be my kiln RPM at 400 feet, what could be my kiln RPM at 420 feet. Like this is all the data we are not taking from some outside formulas or something. We are interpreting our data from our live records. And this is not in the books, or it is not a standard formula. Whatever the parameters we are running in our plant, it is interpolating the same data. Using this technique, we can make anything. We can compare the granulometries in the raw mill section, granulometry in the cement mill. In the cement mill, we can see the particle size distribution. Any graphs, we can just input the data and we can see the results. So this is one module just I want to explain to you. And other than this, I have other modules like to-do list, where we can assign our day-to-day job. We can list our day-to-day jobs. We can track our progress. We can assign to others my tasks. For example, I can assign to others from create task. I can give the responsibility. Any responsibility I can give. So the task will go to the concerned person. So I have some sales data, for example, sales data. This is the entry form. We can enter here. Suppose if I want to see the sales data, I can see the sales data. from here. So this is the sales data. I can view sales data. How is the with respect to pie chart, with respect to column charts, line charts, anything we can see here, we can zoom, we can see here. And any date, suppose I want to see what is the sales during this year, for example, from 010-2021. So I can filter any data, whatever you put here, you can filter, you can track, you can do anything. So next, coming to lubrication, we have our schedules of lubrication. We can assign warning, danger, alarm, when next to do, in how many days. This is the demo session, that's why you are seeing all in red color, and next to do in 24 days, like that. And coming to chart section, maintenance, any graphs, just input the data. You can see which equipment, how many times there is a breakdown, what is the number of breakdowns. Suppose this is 4531 MD1, we have number of breakdowns. 6481 BC400, number of breakdowns. What is the duration, for example. And you can see the same as a pie chart. And coming to refractory, you can schedule when is the next refractory jobs. And coming to Kaizen, you can schedule all the improvement jobs. Coming to department, this is the department index. This is one interesting thing. Here you can schedule each department, schedule their own like checklist. So what are the department sheets has to be followed? For example, yearly budget, refractory consumption, kiln stoppage planning, and what is the duration, who is responsible, monthly AFR, monthly CFT, fans efficiency, monthly clinker, all we can list out here. And as per the schedule, we have to track day to day. For example, monthly pyroheat balance sheet, now it is showing warning. Suppose let's say I updated today, for example, 0726. I updated today, just to some and respect to file. Update. So this became and done, and I have updated the data, so immediately this has become done. So from today it will count 0 days, 1 days, 2 days ago, 3 days ago, 4 days ago, like that. So similarly, we have safety observations. Here we can include what are the safety points, safety statistics. We can module what is safety observation section, cement mill, kiln, raw mill, everything department, responsible department. And what is the safety category, reaction, position, PP, who is the responsibility, type of the response, NAC, severity, minor, serious, fatal, job progress, job complete, everything. And we can list out. It is like a small plant maintenance, plant management tool, where we can upload all the data. Even we can track, we can see the records, we can download as Excel. We can download as Excel, for example. Here we can download as Excel. We have PDF option, we have print option, we have download to Excel option. So download to Excel action we have. And download as PDF we have. We can download as PDF all the jobs, all the data, whatever the data is there, we can download as PDF. This will be the downloaded data. So this is what I want to explain in overall. So here you will get the total column in the bottom. What is, you can filter from here. What is the planned? If you put plan, then you will see what is the data from here. What is the breakdown? One second. I can put plant filter records, no data. I can put, sorry, here. Let's track from 2020. So this is the data. I can filter any total number of data, 16. I can put 15, 50, 100. We can, all these are options available. Suppose if I want plant, then I can filter records as plant, all the plant, what is the stoppage, everything, and everything we can see here. So this is what I want to explain. So thank you for your time. Thank you very much. Bye bye.